Word of a proposed bar and after 10 p.m. adult entertainment establishment has area businesses and neighbors fired up.
And they did not hold back tonight. Mike Garofalo joins us live from near San Mateo and McLeod with more on the proposed Atlantis restaurant and bar. Mike?
Cynthia, many of you may remember this building as the old Car Crafters on McLeod. Well, now somebody wants to turn it into a restaurant and a bar. And after 10, they want to have adult entertainment. But that's not sitting so well with neighbors.
Tina Schofield spends a lot of time in the area near San Mateo and McLeod, and she says a bar offering adult entertainment is the last thing the area needs.
I hate it. I live nearby. I like to run and bike here, and if that's here, I'm not going to feel safe at all.
Especially, she says, since there are already two other adult entertainment establishments in the area, TD's and Fantasy World.
I'm very against it. I mean, these children are of an impressionable age, and I just don't want this near my son.
Catherine Aguilar says her son goes to the Learning Center Charter School, located just on the other side of San Mateo, on the other side of Putt-Putt Golf.
Some of the children do walk over to the Circle K during their break time to get sodas or refreshments or whatever, and it's going to be right there in their face.
Even Define Fitness, located right across McLeod, is against it.
Our experience with the other club in this area is that they will be using our parking for the facility, and we've had experiences in the past where people have been injured, even one death, in crossing the street back and forth.
But the lawyer for the proposed club owner says up to now, nobody has accurately described what Atlantis will be.
You're not going to have pole dancers all day long and lap dances. You're going to have a dinner establishment that after 10 o'clock does a Las Vegas-style Moulin Rouge show.
Now, that lawyer also said tonight they plan on putting $1 million into this property, but one of the problems is the parking. We're told there are about 69 parking spots on this property, and maybe as many as 230 diners could be seated in the restaurant, so you figure out the math. That's not going to work out so well for places across the street like Define Fitness and Chili's. A decision could come down as early as within the next week on this. From the state in Northeast Albuquerque, I'm Mike Garofalo, KOAT Action 7 News.
And if the state gives the owners preliminary approval, then it goes to the city for approval as well.